So throw your hands up and fill the next cup. Let's get this started again, 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 again. Me and my whole crew, we live with no rules. Let's get this started again, again. So if you feel like me too, there's only one thing to do. Let's go.
Pay down, call the taxi cab. Got a case in the fridge and a bottle at the crib.
Let's all get twisted, double fist.
Hey, what's up everyone, it's your boy NS Racing 42, aka Nathan Stapleton here, and welcome everyone to season number 2 of the TRN Red Bull Cup Series, and it is now time for the Coca-Cola 600, the longest race of the season, 80 laps here tonight at Charlotte Motor Speedway, for race number 7 of the season, and it will be the last Red Bull Cup Series race under the TRN banner, at least for a good while, as next weekend will be the All-Star Race from Eldora, and that will be under the brand new league name of my own league, NIRA. So, a bittersweet night here tonight, but we ended the biggest two races of the season for each series. So, yeah, tonight, last race for the Rebel Cup Series under the TRN banner. Last chance for these drivers to get a win, lock themselves into the playoffs, and to lock themselves into the All-Star Race next weekend. As you will see later on, maybe tonight or tomorrow, just depends. I will talk about the ways that you're locked into the All-Star Race. So, for everyone that's not in to that classification right now, they have to get a win here tonight or be really high in points to lock themselves into the All-Star Race and not have to go through the open, and that starts, you know, it starts and ends here tonight at Charlotte. The drivers that are locked in to the All-Star Race and to the playoffs for season number 2 so far is Josh South, Christian Russell, Roger Rey, RJ Bishop, Pat Smith, and Matthew Hartford. Those are the 6 winners so far this season. Patrick Smith was all the way locked in because he was the champion and they ended the playoffs in season number 1. So now he's in likely race. So, yeah. Anyway, here is the top 10 in points for the top 10 in points before the Coca-Cola 600, I should say. Josh South has a 17-point gap over James Ellison. Christian Russell is in third, 22 points back. Adam Garcia is in fourth, 24 points back. Travis Crampton is in fifth, 27 points back. Lily Hagen is in sixth, 30 points back. Ryan Kendall is in seventh, 33 points back. Bobby Fraser is in eighth, 35 points back. Roger Rey, our most recent winner at Texas, is ninth, 36 points back. And Nathan Fain is in 10th, 43 points back. So, it's been a pretty good season so far in the Bubble Cup Series. And we are all the way up to the All-Star Race next weekend. And then after Talladega, halfway through the regular season already. So, it's going by fast. Much faster than last season and last year. So, I'm pretty happy about that. And it's going to stay that way. Because I only have, 3 weeks left of school. So, yeah. Anyway, here's the top 10 starting positions for the Coca-Cola 600, the second biggest race of the season, one of the crown jewels. On the pole is Nathan Van, and alongside him is Lily Hagen. Row number 2 is the birthday bash winner, Angel Avell, and the number 1 of James Ellison. Then, in row 3 is Patrick Smith and Quentin Moore. Row number 4 is the 72 of Tyler Franken, and the 17 of John Andrews. And rounding out the top 10 is Matthew Hubbard in the number 11, and Andrew Miller in the 48. He's had a terrible sophomore season, well, the terrible second season so far. Last in the points as of now. He needs a good one here tonight to build up his confidence. So, with that being said, let's get these 40 cars rolling off for the final Red Bull Cup Series race under the TRN name. The final Red Bull Cup Series race before the Season 2 Red Bull All-Star Race. And let's get these cars rolling off for the Season number 2, Coca-Cola 600.
Drivers, start your engines.
All 40 cars are going to get rolling off here for the 2019 Coca-Cola 600 for the final time for the Red Bull Cup Series to be under the TRN name. I'm going to say that all night long because it's a big deal. Finally, everyone is going to roll off. Third time I've tried that. So, 80 laps of racing here tonight for the Coca-Cola 600. If it stays green all the way, which I highly doubt it, based off of testing, then it will be a two-stop race. It's going to be a long one here tonight, but it's going to be fun. Nathan Finn, Larry Hagan, Angel Oliveira, James Ellison, Patrick Smith, Quinton Moore, Tyler Fink, John Andrews, and then Matthew Alford and Andrew Miller. And then 11th and 12th are Stuart Haas teammates Colton Yell and Ryan Kendall, Trey White and Josephine O'Neill. And the top 15 is rounded out by Jose Mills. So, it's going to be a great race here tonight, the Coca-Cola 600. The longest race of the season. 80 laps. Here we go. Nathan Fan, Larry Hagan. The final time we are racing in the Rebel Cup Series under the TRN name. Nathan Finn will lead lap number one. Second is the birthday bashman, Angel Oliveira in 18. Patrick Smith down with Larry Hagan for third. These guys will get somewhat spread out, but based off of testing, even though testing does not matter that much on it, I mean, it should be pretty close. And as the one goes on, they will get a little bit closer and so on. So, yeah. Still have to watch out for three wide though. Nathan Fain is trying to have a little gap. And these guys are going to wash up a lot in turn 1 and 2. And that could be a trouble spot later on in this race. Nathan Fain looking strong for now. But Angel Oliveira closing in on Nathan Fain. Really ducked down to the inside. Yes, he will. Looking for the race lead from Fain. But Fain with a huge one up top and 1 and 2. But then Avail is going to make it about even off of turn 2. And Avail will take the race lead away from Nathan Fain. Tyler Fink is in second, and our season 1 champion Patrick Smith is in third. But Larry Hagan is in fourth, trying to get by Nathan Fain and maybe even Patrick Smith. Matthew Hawthorne, he's trying to get his second win of the season. He won at our club, if I remember right. Trying to win here at Charlotte, Trey White in the number 15 as well. And this is about what I expected. Not too spread out, but not really as pack racing entirely. Tyler Fink running about a lane lower than Avail, trying to get a little bit of an advantage, and he's going to duck down to the inside. Meanwhile, they are three wide for fifth. and Fan is driving back like a walk. His call has fallen off big time early on, as I think Jose Mills was got into the outside wall off of turn four. Still three wide here. Oh, jeez, I thought that Miller was going to make it four wide there. This is very close. And they are going to settle it back down. Avail still out front. Smith tried getting by Frank on the inside lane, but he was not able to do it, and he's going to stay in third. And that's what I'm talking about. Because they were going three wide there, just for a lap or two, these guys to spread out now. So, don't want to go three wide, or that will happen. William Blatt, he is in fifth now in this number 88 machine. One of two Amazoto calls here tonight. Nathan Fain trying to work his way back up to the front in that number 95. Tyler Fink now trying to make this inside lane work on Angel Rivera. Doesn't get the best of ones. He's going to have a shot at it off of turn two and maybe going into turn three. No, never mind. He comes back to Smith though on the outside lane. Can he make something work up there? He's going to try. Fink will have second that lap. But Smith looking pretty good on his outside lane. And he's going to take second away from Tyler Fink. Defending series champion looks like to be on the roll right now here early on in this race. 1/8 of the way through the Coca-Cola 600 at the line this time by Tyler Fink. Oh, back to Smith. Thought about making it 3 wide, but he thought better of it. But now Tyler Fink and Smith are going to battle for second. Can Smith get a good one off of turn two again? No, but he gets a good one in 3 and 4, and he's going to keep second. Behind him, William Block, Haken, and Fink making it 3 wide for third. William Block seems to have a pretty strong call here on the long one. And so does Matthew Holford, Trey White, Colton Yeo, Andrew Miller. So, looks like some calls like Nathan Fahan seems to have a short one call. And others seem to have a long one call, and some just have a good call, period. Like Patrick Smith, he is going to try to take the race lead away from Avila to the inside. Trying to do a little bit of a side draft there. Can he make a pass on the inside? He hasn't done that yet here tonight, at least up front. And yes, he will. He's going to slide. But Avila is going to do a crossover. What a move. A crossover from Angel Avila. But Smith seems to get really good ones in 1 and 2. But he got way too high in 1 and 2 that time. Way too high. Got into the marbles or something. And Avila easily will take the lead back. And it might be a Joe Gibbs 1-2 here. As that's 3 wide. Behind him, contact with Fink and Haken. Sorry if you hear a cat again. But it looks like it might be Joe Gibbs 1-2. Smith trying to make that outside lane look again, but it does not work again for him, and it's Joe Gibbs 1-2. But Trey White has another good call, especially on this long one, and he's in third. And right now, is the top 9 are under a blanket. Trey White for premium. Now going for second for on Matthew Holford. These guys are definitely at spinning main in 1 and 2. But 3 and 4 is a little bit less forgiving. They are mostly two lanes closest to the white line. But in 1 and 2, they will wash up the track and try diming a ton. And caution's out. Oh! Eli Bright and Stephen Thompson. Tough wait for Eli Bright and Stephen Thompson there. Meanwhile, race back to the line. And it will be Angel Avila that will win the race back to the line. Tori White in second, Matthew Hufford in third, Tyler Fink in fourth, and Patrick Smith in fifth, and then Colton Yeo, Lily Hagen, Andrew Miller, Lillian Blatt, and Nathan Fay in the top 10 after 17 laps here in the Coca-Cola 600. Doesn't look like it's too much damage to the Eli Wright, but he is going to pit. Looks like he might have a small hood buckle. Stephen Thompson looks to be mostly okay, but we will have to see what happened to those two. And with 17 laps in and about 28 laps on tires and fuel, I think everyone's going to come in here. I would be shocked if someone decides to stay out. And that's not the case. Everyone is pitting here on lap 19 in the Coca-Cola 600. Can Angel Avila beat out Patrick Smith, Matthew Hartford, Tyler Fink, and Trey Wright? Trey Wright and Angel Avila? I think Trey Wright got it. Colton Yeo with a great pit stop. Ryan Kent, Stuart Haas Racing. Great pit stops by all four of the crews. And I think it was Trey Wright in number 15. What was it? No, it was Angel Avila by inches. Avila wins the race off the pit road. Trey Wright a close second. Tyler Fink will restart third. Colton Yeo in fourth. Patrick Smith stays in fifth. Lillian Block in sixth. Matthew Hufford in seventh. Andrew Miller in eighth. Ryan Kendall will restart in ninth. And then Lily Hagen will restart in tenth. So, that being said, let's see what happened to cause the first caution of the night in the Coca-Cola 600 and for Eli Bright and Stephen Thompson. So this is what happened. Keshawn Richardson made contact with his teammate and then shoved Eli Bright into the Alliance team, Stephen Thompson, and into the wall he went, and then nowhere to go back into the wall and nowhere to go for Stephen Thompson. The second hit for both of them. So RCL and the Alliance teammate all involved here in this one, but definitely Eli Wright and Stephen Thompson with the biggest hits out of the three. Another look at it, as you can see, they were deep in the pack, and then right there, contact with the 3 and 31, and then bam, contact with the 3 and 13 into the wall and into that angled wall or coming to the line. Could have been much worse. Luckily, it wasn't. But tough way for Eli Bright and the number 3, and along with Stephen Thompson. Welcome back here for the TRN Rebel Cup Series Coca-Cola 600. And it will be Angel Avila leading us back to the green. And in fact, Eli Bright, he never went a lap down. He's on the tail end of the lead lap, though, and with that slight hood buckle that he has, how much of a problem will that be? Just have to wait and see. Avila, Wright, Fink, Yeo, and Smith back green on lap 22 in the Coca-Cola 600. Tyler Fink to the inside of Trey Wright in the 15. a failure. It's going to get by Eli Bright, and 20 White is going to get screwed over by the number 13. I mean, by the number 3. And he's going to just bring it down to pit road. Oh, Jesus! Stephen Thompson! Big kick for Stephen Thompson into the air and into the catch fence. Oh, God. Ha, Sheila. Anyway, huge hit. And Noah Clifton, unfortunately, nowhere to go, and he has heavy damage in that double zero. Stephen Thompson is still going after getting ill. Impressive. Anyway, back out front. This field is fairly spread out now. Fairly spread out because of that. And right now, Angel Vale is still out front. And now, Clifton and Thompson are now onto pit road. Tough wait for those two. Right now, it's Angel of Baylor and Coutinho 1-2. And then 3 wide for third between Smith, Fink, and White. And Patrick Smith moves up to third. Sorry, I'm trying to deal with my cat. It's, oh, jeez. Eli Bright, right in front of these leaders once again. Back out on the racetrack, he's going to be a problem for the rest of the race until he gets eliminated completely. Patrick Smith is going to get held up a little bit by Eli Bright. Stephen Thompson is still going to be out on track somehow. Oh, yeah. I don't know. This is a real start to the 600 already here at Charlotte. Patrick Smith is going to finally goodbye Eli Bright, and so will Tyler Fink. And Stephen Thompson only going 170. Oh, jeez. Angel Avila seems to have the dominant call of the night, at least for now. In the first 28 laps. Now, because they appeared on that 18, it's probably going to be about 56 laps till that 56 till we pit again, if we make it till then. Colton Yo closing in on the number 18. Top 6 have all made it. Oh my god, my cat. This is a sloppy recording. Anyway, Angel Avila still out front. Colton Yo in second. Patrick Smith in third. Tyler Fink in fourth. And then Trey White in fifth. William Block in sixth. Lily Hagen in seventh. John Andrews in eighth. RJ Bishop in 9th and Nathan Stapleton in 10th. Mouse out the top 10. Avail one's wide. Fairly wide. And new race leader Coutinho and then the number 12. But it might not last long because here comes Patrick Smith, the number 10. He gets tight or something going into 3. And Coutinho is going to, for now, take the race lead away in the Coca-Cola 600. Battle for third between Avila and Fink. And now can Smith close in on Coutinho? Coutinho's been he's been driving a long time in this community. Rookie in the Rebel Cup Series, but not as a driver. Compared to Smith, close in on Coutinho. These two have been by far the best forwards so far here tonight. Stephen Thompson, going 173. We're going to catch up with him in just a couple of laps. Patrick Smith, though, looking to the inside of Colton Hill, no, can't get there. Top 5, underweight blanket. Avail, trying to get by Patrick Smith. And Trail White, trying to get by Tyler Fink. Colton Hill starting to have a little bit of a gap now on these two, well, on these now five. And hello, Stephen Thompson, and the number 13. Patrick Smith is going to be the first one to get screwed over by him, unless he decides to make a three wide. Three wide is going to, oh, geez. Three wide contact with Patrick Smith and Trey White. That was a close call right there. Trey White, Emilian Brock, and Patrick Smith still getting screwed over from 13. And ultimately, Trey White is going to be the one that's going to get screwed over the most. Maybe Stephen Thompson, with him going not as slow, but not as fast, he can go more full throttle. But now they're going to get by him because he does not have the straightaway power as everyone else. Colton Yeo out front here at Charlotte. Angel Avila is in second. Tyler Fink is in third. William Brock is in fourth. Patrick Smith is fifth. Trey White is in sixth. John Andrews is in seventh. Nathan Fayen in eighth. Lily Hagan in ninth. And RJ Bishop in tenth. As we are four laps away from halfway through the Coca-Cola 600 and Angel Avila, the dominant car of the night so far, trying to take the race lead back from Colton Hill, and he's going to easily take it back. As I don't know if Andrew had a problem or what, but he just came off a pit road. So unfortunately, another bad night here and another bad race for Andrew Miller. Angel Avila is not having a bad night so far. Three laps away from halfway through the Coca-Cola 600, and he's been by far the most dominant car of the race up to this point. And if he keeps this up, he might get a bonus point for leading the most laps here tonight. But Tyler Fink seems to have a good car right now. William Brock is having a good one and a good car. So is Colton Hill, so is Pat Smith, so is Trey White. And right now it's just these top six, because seventh on back is like 3 seconds away. And 3 seconds back from these top six. So right now, if we don't get another caution, it might be these top six for the race win. Next time by, we will be halfway through the Coca-Cola 600. Tyler Fink is out front now, thanks to the help from William Brock in the 88. William Brock, never mind Colton Hill, 3 wide for the race lead, halfway through the Coca-Cola 600. Colton Hill has been one of the two best Ford cars all night long. And so far, it's been all Colton Hill and all Angel Avila to be out front so far that's led the most. And Colton Hill will take the race lead back. And, yeah, take the race lead away and back from William Brock. Patrick Smith is now back up to third. And most ones have not had much speed other than the 9 of Josh South. But William Brock showing speed. Avail dives in deep and will take third away from Patrick Smith. And William Brock trying to take the race lead away from Colton Yeo. Right now it's Hendrick Motorsports, Joe Gibbs, Team Penske, Stuart Haas, TriStar, and Premium, the top six. And the only one to have a win so far this season in the top six is Patrick Smith in the number 10. William Block, second season, still no win yet on my channel or in the Rebel Cup Series, period. Angel Oveo trying to get his second win in a couple of weeks. William Block way up the racetrack, almost into the wall, two or three times in one and two. And now Patrick Smith is in second and Colton Yeo is in third. The top three best cars so far in the first half of the Coca-Cola 600 are now 1, 2, 3 in the Coca-Cola 600 right now. Patrick Smith with a major one. He's going to try it. Patrick Smith to the inside of Angel Oveo. These guys really washing it up the track a lot now. These tires are definitely falling off. It's been about going on 20 laps, like 17, 18 laps on these tires now. So definitely playing into a factor. Patrick Smith out front now, once again in the Coca-Cola 600. Colton Yeo is in second. Trey White is in third. Trey White seems to have a really good long run car, and Oveo right now is losing it fairly tight with something, and he's falling back in sixth. And right now Patrick Smith is gone, at least trying to get gone from Colton Yeo in the number 12. Trey White is in third, and William Block trying to get fourth away from Tyler Fink. Really, Andrew Miller is going faster than these top six because of fresh tires, so I don't know if he's pulling strategy or what. No, he's not. He's two laps down, so yeah. And oh, never mind. Here we go. Pit stops on that 47. Patrick Smith is in. Angel Oveo is in. Roll Ben Crouch. First round of green flag pit stops of the night in the Coca-Cola 600. Ace Garcia stays out. Matthew Helford stays out. Matthew Helford stays out. Ben Crouch, Chris Salvett, Travis Crampton, Quinton Moore, Sean Richardson, Mark Davison, Diego Yepes all stay out here and do another lap. And we'll pit on that 49. So pit stop started. And Keshawn Richardson stays out again. So he's going to get a bonus point. And he's the last one that has not pitted yet, I might think, besides the cars that have damage. I would expect Keshawn Richardson to come pit this time by, and he will. So, we ranged from lap 47 to lap 50, and that means we will definitely have one more round of pit stops here tonight, no matter if it's under caution or under green. I would think it will probably end up being Colton Yeo in the number 12 to cycle out as the race leader, depending on the 31. He gets a pretty good stop for Keshawn Richardson. It's going to be pretty close. And actually not really. Colton Yeo will cycle out as the race leader here in the Coca-Cola 600. Patrick Smith in second, Trey Wright in third, Million Block in fourth, Tyler Fink in fifth, Angel Avila in sixth, Ryan Kendall in seventh, RJ Bishop in eighth, Sebastian Kukulon in ninth, Madison Tall in tenth. How about Adam Garcia in 11th? 12th is Colton Friesen. 13th is Nathan Fayden. 14th is Roger Rey. Texas winner. 15th is Nathan Stapleton. 16th is Ace Garcia. 17th is Billy Hagan. 18th is Wyatt Walker. 19th is Matthew Alvin. I hope I am doing this right. Yep, 19th is Matthew Holford. And then 20th is Andrew Miller. So he's on a totally different strategy, but he's been 20th, so not too bad. So that's the top 20 after pit stops. Patrick Smith looking to the inside of Colton Yeo. And the longer these guys so go side by side, that's going to allow Trey Wright to close in. Remember, Trey Wright won twice in season number one late in the season, in the second half of the season. He's been quiet so far with Premier this season, but you cannot count this guy out. Patrick Smith trying to take the race lead again from Colton Yeo. And Trey Wright all over the back bumper now of Patrick Smith. Top three are under a blanket. But Colton Yeo with a good one up top. Off of two keeps the race lead away from Patrick Smith. Million Block trying to close in on the top three. But Angel Avila is leading a five-car train of himself, Kendall, Fink, Bishop, Kukulon, and maybe Tall if she can catch up to these. To this five car group. So we're going to get some more calls here as the draft matters somewhat here at this version of Charlotte. And meanwhile, Patrick Smith is out front once again. It's been all Patrick Smith, Colton Yeoman, and Angel Avila. But Trey Wright has been pretty quiet so far here tonight, but it has been in the top five all night. Same with Million Block. Tyler Fink has been in the top six all night, so for the most part, the top six, in fact, yeah, the top six are all the same. So, there's still the fastest cars right now here at Charlotte. As, hello, Stephen Thompson again in the number 13. So, gonna easily get by him, at least the top three will. Really, Block is gonna get held up by him a little bit, but now Stephen Thompson is gonna let him by. Two more laps at the line, and we will be 20 laps away from the conclusion of the 2019 Coca-Cola 600 in the final race for the Rebel Cup Series underneath the TRN name, or the TRN banner. Trey Wright in second, Colton Yeo trying to take second away from Trey Wright. And with these guys going side by side, that's going to allow Block, Avila, and Fink to close in. And what do you know, the six fastest cars of the night are all in a group once again. But there's more cars now that might be on a hot streak and might be fast. Ryan Kendall, RJ Bishop, three of the four Stuart Haas cars are in the top eight. You cannot count out Madison Tall or Kukulon as well. Because remember, we'll still have one more round of pit stops. And that can change everything. William Block trying to get by Colton Yeo. Trey Wright has fallen back to 6th. 20 laps to go here in the 2019 Coca-Cola 600. And Andrew Miller just came off of pit road. He is obviously off strategy from everyone else. So, just trying something. But But Andrew Miller, he's done. He's done with pit stops for the night, but under that first round of pit stops, he only made up to 20th about. So I don't think he's going to end up finishing much better than that. Coach Neal now dropping back to the end of this five-car group. And with these guys battling, Patrick Smith, season number one champion, is gaining on his lead. Remember, in season number one, he was the first driver to get two wins in the Red Bull Cup Series, period. And he was the first one to do it in season number one. In six races this season, we've had six different winners. If Patrick Smith can get the win here tonight, he will get his second win of the season, and second win for, and he will be the first person to get the second win of the season, two seasons in a row. So Patrick Smith, fairly strong once again. He's been strong once again this season, consistent and fast. But he washes wide in 1 and 2. Trey White trying to take second away from Angel Avila. And looks like he will. Avila way wide, almost 3 wide for third, but not quite. Avila went way wide. And look who's creeping his way up here. Phoenix winner, we know. Atlanta, yeah, I think the Atlanta, RJ Bishop, has joined the top six, and now it's became seven, top seven. But also Ryan Kendall, Colton Yeo, and Madison Tall, trying to catch up with the top seven. In the middle, he is two laps down. He might get one of his laps back. Who knows? As meanwhile, new race leader Trey White out of nowhere takes the race lead away from Patrick Smith. Fourteen laps to go in the Coca-Cola 600. Patrick Smith trying to get by Trey White once again. He's going to have a one off of four. Here he comes, Patrick Smith to the inside of Trey White. And at this point of the race, most likely, if you cycle out to be the race leader, there's a good chance that you will win this race as the three wide back in there. Ryan Kendall's going to let Kukulon and Bishop go by. And Kukulon having a great night here tonight in that number 34 machine. Right now, it is Patrick Smith, William Blatt, Trey White, and Tyler Fink. And then Colton Yeo in fifth. And don't mind Andrew Miller, he's just on flush tires and blowing by these guys on old tires. Avila, ever since that first round of green flag pit stops, he's just been stuck back here in like 5th or 6th place. Can't get by anyone else. Smith did get by Trey White, and now Trey White trying to get by Patrick Smith once again. Like I said, Trey White has been quiet but smooth here tonight in that number 15. And right now, the top three are all veterans. White, Brock, and Smith. All pretty good veterans as well. William Brock got by Colton Yeo. He's on fresh tires. And he's like 5/10 of a second faster than these guys. So he's easily going to get one of his laps back right away just by racing these guys. 10 laps to go, by the way, here in the Coca-Cola 600. And that's 3 wide, but they're going to settle it back down Guglon, he might be a threat. Depending on how good of a pit stop he gets, he might become a threat. And here's my question, when will we have pit stops? With 9 laps to go and the Coca-Cola 600 and the middle is going to get one of his laps back. When will these guys pit? We know that Andrew Miller is good to make it on tires and fuel. But when will these leaders pit? Colton Yo, trying to take the race lead away from Trey White. 8 laps to go in the Coca-Cola 600. I don't know, it's gonna be close. All these guys gonna try to stretch it from here. I highly doubt it, but who knows? Who honestly knows? But 32 laps would be stretching it. So they might be 4 or 5 laps short. They might just be 4 or 5 laps short. Seven laps to go. Is anyone going to pit this time by? No, they don't. Twin White trying to get by Coutinho once again. Tyler Fink, though, is in third. Washes up the racetrack a little bit. These top three are gone and have a little bit of a gap from fourth on back. They stand by, 5 laps to go. They stay out. Are they going to really try to stretch it? 5 laps to go in the Coca-Cola 600. Some of these guys might be trying to stretch it all the way. Lap times have definitely fallen off though. Is anyone pitting this time by? No, no one pits. Actually, yes they do. Angel Avail pits. These guys are pitting with 4 laps to go. 3 of them did at least. Can these guys make it 4 laps to go in the Coca-Cola 600? Trey White can't make it. He's coming in. Can Colton Yeo make it? 3 laps to go in the Coca-Cola 600. To be honest, I think some people might be able to save it, and some people might not be able to save. 3 laps to go. Will Colton Yeo or Tyler Fink pit? I think they are pitting. Yes, they are. Does anyone dare to stay out? Angel Avail already pitted. Matthew Holford's the new race leader. Travis Crampton stays out. So does White Walker. So does Ace Garcia. Travis Crampton is in second, trying to go 2 wins in a row on my channel. Does he stay out? No, he pits. Can Matthew Holford get it done? White flag is in there. Final lap for Matthew Holford. Can he make it all the way? Can he make it? One more lap. Half a mile left. Can he make it? Yes, he will. On fuel strategy and on fuel mileage. Matthew Holford, win number 2 of the season. And he will win the final Red Bull Cup Series race under the TRN banner. And he will be the first driver to get his second one of the season, and he does it on fuel strategy late in the going. Heck, I think he was the only driver that was able to make it all the way. He saved just enough. How about that? Matthew Hartford and that number 11 FedEx team for Joe Gibbs Racing. Second win in 6 races for that rookie. What a job. Saved enough fuel. And he's going to get it done in the second crown jewel race of the season. What a job for Matthew Hartford in the number 11. Colton Yo ends up finishing in second, Tway White in third, could go on in fourth, Tyler Fink in fifth, Travis Crampton though, sure he couldn't make it on fuel, but he still gets sixth place. Another great one for Travis Crampton. Wyatt Walker in 7th, Ace Garcia in 8th, Ben Crouch in 9th, rounds out the cars that were on the lead lap. Mark Davison comes home in 10th, Yepes in 11th, Richardson in 12th, Smith in 13th, Avail in 14th, Kendall 15th, Brock 16th, Tall 17th, Adam Garcia in 18th, Bishop in 19th, Rainey in 20th, and the Mills, Ellison, Fraser, Andrews, Dilello, Ray, Faden, Friesen, Stapleton, Moore, South, Fergus, Russell, Salvett, Miller, all one lap down. Some, most of them, because they pitted late in the going. Eli Bright, 3 laps down. Stephen Thompson, 4 laps down. Lily Hagen, I did not catch that. Lily Hagen, after starting second, he DNS with a tire issue. And for the second straight race, Josephine O'Neill has bad luck. At Texas, she had bad luck. And now she blows up here at Charlotte in the 600. And then Noah Clifton, who got into Stephen Thompson, who caught air off of turn number 4. He's the only car that physically crashed out. Let's see if what happened to first Lily Hagen and then Stephen Thompson and Noah Clifton. So I don't know what happened to Lily Hagen, but this happened on lap 73 to lap 74. He just came on to pit road, and once they got into the pit stall, I guess what I want to say happened was maybe a tire blew, and maybe it broke something underneath here. They couldn't fix it, and they just gave up and put it behind the wall. Tough wait for Lil Hagen. Was inside, I think, the top 10 or top 15 when this happened. Started second, and he's going to finish deep in the field here in the Coca-Cola 600. Josephine O'Neill is battling with Travis Crampton in 29th, and Kaboom it went in 3 and 4, right in front of Travis Crampton. Luckily, nothing bad happened, but just a tough 2 races for this 38 team and for Josephine O'Neill. First, they had some kind of tire issue at Texas, and now here at Charlotte to end the mile and a half swing, they blew up. Tough wait for Josephine O'Neill. So this is what happened that sparked the crash that somehow did not bring out a caution. So we saw that Eli Bright ended up coming down onto pit road right after the restart. And then that stacked up the field. And then the 13 just bam, hooked the corner panel of Noah Clifton and then caught air. Somehow did not knock Stephen Thompson out, but somehow, guess it did enough engine damage. There really is not that much damage, but it did enough damage to knock out Noah Clifton in the 00. Tough point for Noah Clifton. It's not his day for the Aussie here in the Red Bull Cup Series. So that's what happened to Noah Clifton, Stephen Thompson, Lily Hagen, and Josephine O'Neill. Thank you guys so much for watching for the 2019 Coca-Cola 600. Matthew Holford, congratulations to you. Second win of the season. You win it on fuel strategy, good job. And you win the final Rebel Cup Series race under the TRN name. Because next weekend for the All-Star race, it will be under the NIRA. So, that should be fun. Thank you guys so much for watching. Congratulations to Matthew Holford for getting the final Rebel Cup Series win under the TRN banner. The points, the Rookie of the Year points, and the spawn outs are coming up next year. And that's going to wrap it up. Thank you guys so much for watching. Congrats to Matthew Holford. And until tomorrow, for what should be an amazing race for the NAPA IndyCar Series finale. 150 miles, I should say, 60 laps. The Indianapolis 150. Double points event. Right now, Dash Bowen has a 44-point lead. It's going to take a miracle for anyone to get by him. But you know what? Crazier things have happened at the Brickyard, and we're going to see what exactly what happened after 60 laps of racing, one of the longer races of the season, of the year. Three races in the row, really, that are pretty long. The Ultimate Street 500, the Coca-Cola 600, and then the Indianapolis 150. Coming up tomorrow afternoon, and that will be the final TRN race that I will do for probably a long time. I will go more deep into it tomorrow, but yeah. Thank you guys so much for watching. Congrats to Matthew for winning the Coca-Cola 600. Until tomorrow, for the Indianapolis 150 and to crown a champion in the NAPA IndyCar Series, I'm in the NS Racing 42, aka Nathan Stapleton, and I will see you guys tomorrow for Indianapolis 150. Bye!